3.2 example one, we start to do some division, and it gives us the information. It tells us what p of x is, and then it identifies that we're dividing by x minus 2. And I want to write at least the start of the division statement here. What we are doing is we're taking 5x cubed. Now, when we talk about writing polynomials out, and you're used to this with quadratics, we should put the powers of the variable in descending order. So I'm going to put that negative 13x squared second, then plus 10x, and then minus 9. All of that is being divided by x minus 2. Now, we'll talk about this more because there is an example later in the notes where this happens. If we didn't have a term that contained x squared, for this long division process to work correctly, we would have to include 0x squared. So when you write that p of x, you should have the highest degree first, and then each degree, even if it means writing a coefficient of 0, until you have the constant written last. Now, this is going to guide us to the division statement itself, but in order to get that q of x, the actual quotient, we have to do our long division. So I'm going to write out inside the division symbol, long division symbol, 5x cubed minus 13x squared plus 10x minus 9, and I'm going to divide that by x minus 2. Now, that technique, and this is going to be something I'm going to say 100 times, maybe not in this video, but in all the videos, is we take the leading term of p of x, and we divide it by the leading term of our divisor, that x minus a. So 5x cubed divided by x yields 5x squared. That result, I'm going to multiply back onto my divisor, which gives me 5x cubed minus 10x squared, and I'm going to subtract that. Now, those brackets are really a lifesaver because it does mean that I am taking negative 13x squared and subtracting negative 10x squared. Now the 5x cubes will cancel. And if I take negative 13 and I subtract negative 10, I'm left with negative 3x squared. Now, there is still more to this polynomial. We still have the plus 10x and we still have the negative 9. So we are going to start that technique all over again. So negative 3x squared, the leading term of p of x, because there's only negative 3x squared plus 10x plus minus 9, sorry, left. Negative 3x squared divided by x is going to give me negative 3x. And I'm going to take that result and multiply it back onto my divisor, which gives me negative 3x squared plus 6x. And I'm going to subtract that. This step is a great example of why I put that bracket there. So many students will write negative 3x squared and think that they've already considered that they're subtracting. That negative 3 is just the coefficient on that term. So negative 3x squared minus negative 3x squared, they will cancel. 10x minus 6x is 4x, and that negative 9 remains. All right, one last time here then. I'm going to take the leading term of p of x, which is 4x now. I'm going to divide that by x. That gives me positive 4. I'm going to take that positive 4, multiply it back onto my divisor, which gives me 4x minus 8. I'm going to subtract that. The 4x's cancel. Negative 9 minus negative 8 is negative 1. And this is my remainder. Now, what this is going to allow me to say, and I'm just going to try to remember my remainder was negative 1, is I can now write out that division statement that the polynomial divided by x minus 2 yielded a quotient of 5x squared minus 3x plus 4. So this is q of x right there, the result of the division. And then I have to add the remainder that is yet to be divided. I'm going to write it as the addition of negative 1 over x minus 2. Now, you could write this, and I'll just kind of make another equal sign here, as 5x squared minus 3x plus 4 minus 1 over x minus 2, because really those are equivalent to each other. Now, that's our division statement. But what I did is I kind of skipped B here. Oh, no, sorry, that is A, right? Divide the polynomial, we did that. So B, to identify any restrictions on the variable, because we have x minus 2 in a denominator, it's very important that x cannot be equal to 2. Because that would cause us to divide by 0, and we can't do that. Now, to write the corresponding statement that can be used to check the division, really what we're going to do is we're going to manipulate that to check if p of x is equal to q of x times x minus a plus the remainder. And this is effectively just verifying our answer to see if we've done it correctly. So in order to do that, I'm actually just going to steal this onto a new page because there's a lot of stuff going on this page. Maybe I'll try to take this whole, let's just take this. And we're going to check to see if it's correct. And again, I think mathematically, it's important that all I'm really doing here is I'm multiplying each term by x minus 2. But I'm going to write that division statement out again just to make sure we see it. I want to see if p of x is equal to q of x times x minus a plus the remainder. And just to reiterate, this negative one is my remainder. This expression right here is q of x. X minus 2 is the x minus a in that form. And then finally over here is p of x. Now I'm going to substitute those in because we want to actually check if this is going to be correct. So I am going to see, and we'll check and verify in a second, if 5x cubed minus 13x squared plus 10x minus 9 is equal to 5x squared minus 3x plus 4 times x minus 2 plus negative 1. Now, we have done some verification throughout the course. It's really important you remember what it means. It means that you're going to take your solution, in this case the division statement, and ensure that the left-hand side is equal to the right-hand side. This is why we spend so much time on the distributive property in grades 10 and 11. You need to make sure that the two terms get multiplied onto all three in the other bracket. And I like to show that with my arrows. I'm going to talk through those really quick. So x times 5x squared is 5x cubed. X times negative 3x is negative 3x squared. X times 4 is 4x. Then I have negative 2 times 5x squared, that's negative 10x squared. Negative 2 times 3x is positive 6x. Negative 2 times positive 4 is negative 8. And then we have the negative 1 for my remainder at the end. To fully verify this, I'm going to collect my like terms. So 5x cubed, negative 3x, and negative 10x squared, are going to give me negative 13x squared. Then I have my positive 10x, and then finally I have my negative 9. And if you take a look at those two side by side, I hope we can agree that that's true. And I really want to reiterate this, that the right-hand side right here is an equivalent form of the left-hand side. And this is something that we do so much in math that we're not changing the value of our polynomial, we're changing the appearance of our polynomial. They are equivalent forms of that function, and in a lot of different situations, the right-hand side is actually much better to work with, especially when the remainder is zero. In fact, 3.3 is an entire lesson dedicated to how can we make sure that a remainder is zero, because that's going to allow us to factor these polynomials. Definitely a fair amount of work in these questions. You have to practice long division in order to get good at it.